Hi, I'm Melissa. I go by Her Art She Loves. I am a sculptor of mixed media robot sculptures. I've been making them for the last 6 years. I create robots out of polymer clay and wire that I coil into little springs and then put everything together and then bake and paint them. I have about 20 different styles, from robot cats and dogs to cake toppers. So this is just showing off five or six of the many styles I do, and I always take custom orders, and someone always comes to me with a new idea, from a robot snowman to a robot mermaid, surfers, things like that. So this is just to show off around the holidays. I make Christmas ornaments, and before that, this is a pilgrim couple I made a few years ago. They haven't been adopted yet, so I will make little pilgrim couples, and then next up I will make little snowmen and so on. So this little couple here are about as big as I make my sculptures. They're about 6 inches. They're a little jigglier than the newer pieces I make. And these are all polymer clay wire, and their shininess is actually a little mica powder over the clay, and then finished off with a little varnish and acrylic paint. And this is my most popular and standard style of wedding cake topper. I only pre-make a few at a time, and then most of the time I'm doing custom versions where they're colors for the wedding. They usually include cats and dogs, little robot cats and dogs with them, top hats, glasses, things like that. But if people can't wait for my turnaround time to make their one-of-a-kind little sculpture, then I have a few ready to adopt. And this little guy here is one of five robots that were used in an indie horror movie called Hellbenders in 2011. Five of them went to New York, four came back to me. The other three are currently on display, and this little guy is in my workspace right now. The prop master for the film discovered me on Etsy, and I filled out a little bit of paperwork, and they paid for them to be shipped by FedEx to New York for 1 week, filmed their little scenes, and then were sent back to me, and I was paid with a thank you in the credits. And so I keep this little guy. Everyone wants to adopt him, but I'm holding on to him for a few more years. And I do recreate him by request. The style's a little more grungy than I do now, but I keep him on hand because it was such a fun experience. Throughout the year, in between custom orders and seasonal pieces, I just make little cats and dogs, because robot cats and dogs, everyone loves them. These are all postcards, photos I actually took myself of sculptures I've made over the last 6 years. The beginning of last year, I started to make, I call this series Professor Bots, the little robots usually reading books, wearing glasses and sneakers, and I've only made about six to date. They take longer than the rest, even wedding cake toppers. I don't sketch anything out or draw it online. I just decide I want to make a robot wearing glasses. And then, oh, if he's wearing glasses, he should have a nice suit. He should be reading a book, wearing sneakers, and go from there. And so I've only made a few of these, but I do make them by request. And I'm hoping to make a few more in the future. And so if I don't have one available, some people have actually started asking for photos of my artwork as well. So I started offering postcards. And when I was only online for 5 of the 6 years offering my artwork, I just had to have a way of having the robots look good to be adopted. So all of these are taken in natural afternoon light and then a quick brightening in Photoshop, and that's it. For workplace kind of geekery, I make robot business card holders. And like this little guy is actually started out completely white polymer clay. And then from there, this is actually all mica powder, which is sort of a version of actually like eyeshadow. It's a very shiny metallic powder. And I rub that on the unbaked piece. So all of this is just all these mica powders rubbed on very delicately so they don't smudge. And then Then from there, I bake him and attach all the metal pieces, and then did a little, actually a matte varnish on him so he wasn't too shiny. And that's a popular style that I offer. This has been another episode of Diversity of Urban Art.